Hare Krishna. Intelligence is meant to be the mind's instructor, not its instrument. All of us have a mind which is impulsive, and we have an intelligence that is reflective. We all can perceive that within us is something which prompts us to act impulsively, self-destructively. And there is something which checks, cautions, evaluates, and then decides. So we need to use our intelligence to evaluate what the mind is saying and then act appropriately. Unfortunately, sometimes the mind can become so forceful that the mind, instead of being controlled by the intelligence, the mind starts controlling the intelligence. And then we act in short-sighted ways, or we act in selfish ways. We act according to our lower desires, but we use our higher intelligence to fulfill those lower desires. And that makes us even more dangerous. Because when we are impulsive, we are just thoughtless. Whatever comes in our mind, we just do it. But when the impulsiveness of the mind is coupled with the reflectiveness of the intelligence, then we scheme to do things in such a way that we think, I will do it and I will avoid the consequences. And I'll do it in such a way that I'll cover my tracks. I'll do it in such a way that I'll eliminate whatever ethical or social restraints might be there and just gratify myself. So such is using the intelligence, or rather abusing the intelligence to fulfill the mind's lower desires, characterizes the ungodly, the demonic. The Bhagavad-Gita talks about such people in the 16th chapter, and in 16.13 it states that idamadyamaya labdham imam prapse manoratham idamasti idamapime bhavishyati punardhanam, says that this much wealth I have attained, and idamadyamaya labdham imam prapse, and this I will get how? Manoratham, by running on the chariot of my mind. Idam asti idamapime, again same point. Oh, now I got this much. Bhavishyati punardhanam, I'll get that also. And this can go so far that when the schemes for earning money, for gratifying one's desires are blocked, then asaumayah tah shatrur hanishye chaparanapi, one may even start eliminating, killing people whom one perceives as obstacles towards the fulfillment of one's desires. So the mind needs to be restrained by the intelligence. That means that when the mind starts coming up, let's do this, let's do that, the intelligence needs to instruct the mind. No, this is terrible. Don't do this. The mind should not be allowed to make the intelligence its instrument. And how do we do that? We need to strengthen the intelligence and weaken the mind. We can strengthen the intelligence by studying the Bhagavad Gita, by nourishing it with a clear, sharp sense of right and wrong, of actions and their consequences. And we can weaken the mind by refusing to expose it to things that will agitate it, and instead exposing it to Krishna, who will pacify and purify it. Then the mind will become the instrument for the intelligence, and then our inner world can work, both the mind and the intelligence can work together for us to do constructive things in the service of Krishna. As Krishna says repeatedly, mai arpita mano buddhir mame vaishyasya samshaya. When our mind and intelligence are offered to him, then we attain him. Thank you. Hare Krishna.